Hi, I'm Ian Cooperman, Strategic Account Manager at ISOS Technology, and I'm here with our Atlassian consultant, Dan Wilson. And today we're going to be talking about metrics, KPIs, and reporting in Jira. All right, so what's the problem? Typically, when we have a messy instance like this, we have challenges understanding the overarching business objectives, right? Because we have a messy instance, you know, difficult to really understand how things are organized, how things are structured, how to report on that. And so, the business objectives that trickle down to the team and into Jira, it starts to create even more of a mess, not being able to connect up those business objectives to the tasks that the teams are doing. What are the other things that we see, Dan?
Quite often, messy Jiras end up in difficult process reporting. So understanding where the team is and how much work is being done is difficult to see across teams that are using different fields and different processes to achieve their reporting. Managing budgets. Teams aren't able to understand how much effort has gone into a project if different parts are being built by different teams using different methods. It's hard to see bottlenecks. Quite often, it's not clear what might be slowing a team down. Is it QA? Is it the development? What's the part that needs to clear out to allow flow of work? Properly allocating resources. Again, if you're not able to report against it, you're not able to understand who might be available or when they're going to be available so you can plan properly. And then it helps the team to understand where they should be focusing and doing the right things. Whenever the messes are there, it's not clear what that is. Teams can't focus on the right thing at the right time.
All right. So how do we solve the problem? The first thing that we want to do is obviously clean it up, right? We want to clean up. We want to consolidate. So that is our main focus. Find the configurations that are no longer being used in the instance, get rid of those, and then start to look at, how do we consolidate down into, more standardized configurations. And, one of the things that we look at is alignment, right, Dan?
Yeah, the alignment is key for workflows and statuses to really come together and help the teams understand where they are. That consolidation work is looking at what is common across the teams and how can we reduce the noise, making sure that everyone is able to understand what's important. Part of that is the reporting solutions. How does the organization report today? Are they getting the answers to the questions that they really want to ask? Doing this, they can use external reporting tools, or they can also integrate additional tools. But being able to have everything in alignment is what helps make that reporting possible. What are some other pieces of the reporting you've noticed that help you?
Yeah, I mean, I can think of a client that we have right now where, they want to install something like Jira Align or have more meaningful reporting coming out of their instance. And so we started that engagement talking about reporting. But what we ended up doing is really focusing on the cleanup and consolidation efforts that we've been talking about. That way they can actually efficiently report on the metrics that they're looking for. So really important to have a clean, organized instance to be able to support that. So, well, how does ISOS help with this? Well, again, we, back to how do we solve the problem? We come in and do that. We implement a cleanup effort. We make sure that there is standardization across your organization. What are some other things, Dan, that we've helped out with?
Coming in with fresh eyes, quite often ISOS is able to, in that implementation of the cleanup efforts, identify things that your users have gotten used to seeing. And so they kind of look over them or glaze them. It's kind of like editing a paper. You've read that word that's spelled wrong so many times, your brain's just looking past it. And so we help you identify and make those alignments that you might be missing. From there, we're also able to start looking at your reporting with you and make sure that it's looking at the correct data to give you the answers you need for the questions that are out there. There's many tools that we like to implement, and we want to be sure and use the correct one to answer the questions you have. And then, as always, we looked for knowledge transfer opportunities. How can we help you understand the way the reporting is configured and what behaviors are driving the data that's coming out of that?
Thanks for joining us as we talked about metrics, KPIs, and reporting in Jira. So for more information, check out our webinar, 5 Rules for Cleaning and Organizing Your Atlassian House, at the link below.